In America, we complain too much. Yes, I'm a sick motherfucker that enjoys to turn on the stupid box television. And on the Spanish television show, Spanish channels, KMX or Univision, whatever fucking channel it is, they pause to do an interview on flashbacks on certain moments in time for a famous couple or a celebrity couple or the celebrity and their families. And the dude from El Gordo y la Flaca, the fat dude, is interviewed with his daughter. And it's brought up to, it's made a point that, you know, sometimes people don't understand how difficult it is to have, to be with, to be the daughter of someone who's world famous. And I thought, you know, would you really go up to some poor cunt that's starving in a North Korean death camp and say, you know what, oh man, did you have a rough day? Oh man, have you just eaten a handful of rice since for today and yesterday? Oh my goodness, oh, I could feel your pain. Let me tell you about this, man. You know, my dad is world famous. And like, you know, people want to write stuff about me on the tabloids, you know. That's pretty hard. And they say mean things. You know, it's sort of like starving and being beaten by guards and working in the snow in just your underwear. Yeah, same thing. And this video is retarded because you're making a video about complaining and you're complaining on it too. Yes, true. Am I holier than thou? Nope. I have a cup of water next to me. Would I prefer it? An ice chilled with some ice in it, Fiji water with maybe a lemon wedge or lemonade or a Pepsi or a Coke or a Fanta. No, I think I can make it with the water. I'm pretty sure. I think so. I think I'll make it. What do you think? I think I'll be all right. Again, a lot of props to the people that have been through, you know, tough times, hard times, sad times, depressing times, painful, and you've overcome hardship to still be standing. And even though that sucks, what you went through, to realize what darkness is, I'll just keep going forward, man. Because I think the moment we start to say, you know what? You know, mean words. Those are painful. Those are hurtful. I believe when you do that, you lessen the pain tolerance for the listener, for the viewer, for anyone observing it. And I don't get that, man. I wonder if it's pain, or I think pain can be one of the things that tells people not to pursue their goals, not to pursue that goal in their mind that they had. Oh my goodness, when am I going to get the recognition? When am I going to get paid? When will I have the nice things? When will I become world famous? When will somebody love me? You know, at times I would like to complain about the traffic in Los Angeles, but then I become grateful for it. Maybe I'd be like, "Fuck, man, I need to go take a shit. I'm fucking hungry." Looking forward to sucking out them titties, yo. Gonna go see that ass. But in another video, as mentioned, a million people equals a million opportunities. Because of so many people here in Los Angeles, it just, everyone trying to pursue something, excel in one thing, be an example of excellence in this thing, or act a fool in this way. A combination of people out there. And the opportunities out there. I don't think I'm making my point clear. Because as I see these people, as I see people, just to count their possible customers, possible fucks, possible relationships that are could be of value, personal, professional, and intimate. It's been a while since I used to associate with people that, like, oh, I'm too tired. Or better yet, surround myself with people like that. And I think at times that it could sound weird or twisted, or even the idea of lonely, to do your own thing. But I think when we start missing out on things, missing out, you're missing out on life, man. I don't believe it. How many people just want to... If you're missing out on the barbecues or the birthday parties, what happens there? Oh, man, one day we're going to go to France, man. One day we're going to go to Italy. One day we're going to do this, we're going to do that. Oh, my job sucks. Donald Trump ate my homework. Again, with all that stuff, with all those sorts of types of distractions that people have to offer, that people want to get attention for, I just think, fuck that, man. Fuck that shit. Started checking out the YouTube channel of CBS News. I don't know how to feel amused or disturbed when I read when I see the stories on murders and robberies, just death. In places by places where I've been to go eat, fill up on gas, visit a friend, conduct some business. It's just life, man. This one lady got her necklace snatched. Fucking uses it, doesn't even fucking provide a description of the motherfucker. Height or race or anything. And what the fuck was the remark? I'm thinking, she doesn't deserve this. She's an old lady. Another old lady that got attacked while walking her dog. I think in Irvine. They caught the motherfucker right outside, but she got punched in the head right outside the right outside her home. the stupid kids are like, you know, no one deserves this. And like, no one deserves this. And I can't believe it's unimaginable that someone would do this to somebody else. And then I think, you know, if you really believe that, you can't imagine that. You are living a very sheltered life, a very selfish life. A selfish life that pretends to care. What does that mean, man? Well, where do I work on this? I believe that if I keep working on this, make another piece, resell to my customers, get more customers, do more world traveling, that I'll create a nice piggy bank. And with that piggy bank, I think, should the day come where I choose to say, man, I retire, man, this is good enough for, good enough for me. Or I want to get away to somewhere that's quiet. Well, you need money for that. Quiet, that's... You know what, I'm trying to think about it. That's luxury now, quiet. No, not a city view, not even a beach trip or a fucking jacuzzi, but quiet, quietness. I think that I could complain about this or that. Okay, but what would that do, man, except annoy the audience and, if anything, also enable the audience to also complain. Now you have more, and then you'll have just more complainers around. Yeah, you know, people that complain about crime, just complain. Don't fucking do anything about it. I think the same motherfuckers that will go watch Thor and Incredible Hulk movies think, yeah, man, you know, I could do that. I could be a hero. Oh man, and the shithole that Venice Beach is turning into. God fucking damn. That sewage is even leaking into Santa Monica. What's that shit? Oh yeah, the security guard that got fucking beat up at a McDonald's in public. Santa Monica, man. Oh man, your dogs, they're too aggressive. Again, I don't get how people could say that about my dogs, but don't won't complain about the fucking nigger that, or the spick or the white trash junkie that's hanging out in the alleys. In the parking lots. Circling, your table. At a cafe, instead just go ahead, run behind the door, run into an office building, and say, "I'm so safe. That was a close one." But don't, you know, go make contact with these motherfuckers. Yeah, man, but you see, man, you know, man, I'm busy, man. It's like, you know, I don't have time for that, man. I was late for work. I was late for work. I was late for school. I can't take you doing that. It's not my job. It's the cop's job. All right. Take into consideration at times when I walk my dog to a place I like to grab some food from. Then I think, fuck though. Oh, the scumbags that still haven't been caught that were assaulting and robbing people in that area. What should I make a YouTube video? Put into my ugly face? The LAPD needs to start patrolling more often because, you know, you guys are paid and, you know, you're supposed to serve the public and, you know, I should be able to go wherever I want for breakfast, for lunch, for dinner. It shouldn't matter. No, this is because of Donald Trump. You know that they're actually, fucking people that call the cops because their kids are don't want to go to school, don't want to wash the dishes, are talking back. Yeah, some cops have told me that shit, and they really wonder. Really wonder about the roles or the role of a parent nowadays. If they even give a shit, if they even give a fuck, if they even know what they're doing. He said these are kids, I think, what is it? under the age of 10, I think. Little fucking elementary school kids. And I know someone's gonna say, think or believe, you know, but you didn't understand, man. If you didn't grow up with a mama, if you didn't grow up with a papa, if you were adopted, if you had step parents, you had an evil stepbrother, an evil stepsister, evil this, evil that, da da da. And this or that happened to you, you know, you gotta accept and do that. Yeah, another thing too from the Cordon de Flaca, which was, you know, it's hard to, he said, fat parent about his slutty ass daughter, wearing a skirt that big, which I like, you know. I love whores, but don't expect me to fucking admire your brain if you're fucking just about showing your butt cheeks. But anyways, yeah, it says something like, you know, it's hard to raise a kid in Miami because of all the distractions that are out there and things to do. I'm not talking about junior high, high school, or college, but the other things. And I thought, how does that, I'm pretty sure it's teen pregnancy, sucking dick, catching AIDS, smoking crack, smoking meth for likes, eating ass to be buddies, eating ass to get a BFF. But instead the father just says, you know, those things that are out there besides school. And I said, how does that, how does that solve anything? It only empowers the darkness, the stupidity out there. You know, more than once I've been told, why do you do this? It's not paying much. Don't you want better things in life? Don't you want a newer car? Don't you want a family? Don't you want wife and kids already? And as I think of that, to me, my brain does not understand those questions because from what I've seen, you know, just married couples going home to, I don't know if it's really home, going to their house or to their apartment, to their condo, seeing their kids. Hey, how's it going? Hey, you're good, doing good, yeah. What do you do, homework? All right, routine, dinner, all right, watch the stupid box for a minute. Okay, that's it, we're done. Instead of getting after it, man, just putting your work out there. And it's led me up to this point right here. That I have heard it from more than one person. Yeah, dude, I'll travel with you. I'll work alongside with you, man. I'll work on my collection. We'll do this and do that, and get all these clients, get all these fucking groupies, get paid, save up, and then we'll start our own shop, do our own business. Do you think you'll accomplish all those goals by saying, nah, man, I'm so tired. Nah, man, it's my day off. Nah, man, it's time off. Nah, man, it's the end of the day. Nah, man, I gotta spend time with the kids. Nah, man. I gotta watch Game of Thrones, man. And And I'll say to be here in this moment here. Let's see how I'll bring out that red right there. Now let's. Something else, let's add some pink over here. Better yet. I lost my train of thought. But it's put me here on this artistic journey of capitalism. And all I can do is just deal with it. Go forward, man. So just be aware of that. The memory's about to get full on this phone. Get after it. No excuses. Go forward. If you do complain, figure out a solution. What can I do about it? What can I change? Look at your resources, but also be resourceful.